Hello dear students, in this video lecture we will learn about errors and types of errors. So this topic is included in our chapter number 1, that is units and measurement. Definition of error. An error is a fault which may occur even in the most careful observation. Error is a deviation of measurement from standard value. Error is an uncertainty in a given measurement. Defects in measurement of physical quantities can lead to errors and mistakes. So how does error arises? We use different instruments to measure different physical quantities in physics. And accuracy of the measurement depends on the accuracy of the instrument used for the measurement. So errors can occur due to instrumental defects, and such errors can be reduced. Error arises due to human limitations and instrumental limitations. Errors cannot be completely eliminated, but they can be reduced. Now we will see the types of errors. There are three main types of errors. Number one, instrumental error. Second, systematic error. And the third one is random error. We will see them one by one. Instrumental error. An error caused due to faulty instrument is called as instrumental error. Or the constant error, when number of observations taken by instrument possess same amount of error, then the error is said to be a constant error. For example, local made measuring scale having faulty calibration on it, say 1 centimeter on the scale, actually corresponds to 1.1 centimeter. The length measured by such scale will differ from its value by a constant amount. In this case, measured length will always be smaller than true value by a constant amount. Hence, such error is called as constant error or instrumental error. Second type is systematic error or persistent error. Error caused due to defective setting of instrument or defective adjustment or unsystematicness of the experimenter is called as systematic error. This error exists due to known causes, and such errors can be reduced or eliminated by identifying the sources of error and applying the rules governing the error. Now, systematic errors may be subdivided into four main types. Which are these four main types? First one is instrumental error. Second is the personal error. Third one is error because of external causes. And the fourth one, error because of defect in the system. The error because of wrong adjustment or the defective settings of the instrument is called as instrumental error. For example, zero error in the micrometer screw gauge. Second example, pointer of the voltmeter if not pivoted at exact zero of the calibrated scale. Now, these types of errors can be minimized by identifying its causes. Now, look at the personal error. As the name suggests, this error is due to carelessness or the fault of an observer while taking readings. Third, error because of external causes. Such errors arise due to changes in environmental conditions, that is, change in temperature, change in humidity, or pressure, etc. If the metal meter scale is used, it shows different readings in summer and winter. Due to change in length of scale itself, due to change in temperature. Now fourth, error due to defect in the system. This error is because of defective or the imperfect experimental setup. For example, while performing experiment to determine coefficient of linear expansion by the Pullinger's apparatus, there may not be proper thermal contact between thermometer and the metal rod. Random errors. The error caused due to experimental conditions and human limitations is called as random error. For example, while performing electrical experiments, if there is voltage fluctuation, then some error may be included. While performing the Stokes experiment to determine coefficient of viscosity of liquid, when metal sphere crosses marking A, stopwatch should be started, and as soon as it crosses the marking B, stopwatch should be stopped. So same person may get different readings because of human limitations. Now see, the random errors can be minimized by taking large magnitude of the physical quantity which is to be measured, taking large number of readings and using smaller least count instruments. Now the next point of discussion is estimation of errors. As we know, errors cannot be completely eliminated, but they can be reduced or minimized. Estimation of errors helps to minimize the error and also to understand accuracy and precision of the measurement process. It also helps to calibrate the instrument. In quality control department, it helps to take decision whether the major job is to be selected or rejected with known tolerance. Now we will see which are the steps for the estimation of errors. The first one is calculate corrected readings if possible. Second step, calculate the mean, that is average value of readings. Third one, calculate absolute error. Fourth one, calculate mean or the average absolute error. Fifth step is calculate relative error. The sixth one is calculate percentage error. To understand the process of estimation of errors and different steps involved in it, we will go through one example. Now look at the corrected reading, how it is calculated. So corrected reading can be calculated by using actual reading plus minus constant error. So if zero error is positive, the correction error is negative, and if zero error is negative, the correction is positive. Mean average reading. To get the mean reading, add all the corrected readings and divide it by total number of readings. In many cases, mean reading is also called as the most probable value. It can be calculated by using this formula. To find out the absolute error, we can use the following formula. The difference between reading or the corrected reading and the mean reading is called absolute error. Average absolute error. The average of absolute error is called average absolute error. Relative error. It is ratio of average absolute error to mean reading. percentage error. It is the product of relative error and 100. See one example of estimation of error. The example is, the diameter of a rod is measured with micrometer screw gauge for 3 times as x1 is equal to 1.223 cm, x2 is 1.224 cm and x3 is 1.224 cm. Calculate the percentage error in measuring diameter of rod if the zero error of micrometer is plus 0.002 cm. Actually, sufficient large number of readings should be taken, but here for simplicity only 3 readings are taken. Now we'll see the solution of this example. The first step is corrected reading. Second step will be mean reading. Third step will be find out absolute error. Fourth step is find out the average absolute error. Fifth step will be relative error. And the sixth one is percentage error. So the first step is finding out the corrected reading. Corrected reading is equal to reading plus minus zero error. Here in given example, zero error is positive. Therefore, correction is negative. That's why corrected reading will be as shown in this slide. Now find out the mean reading. Mean reading is equal to XM is equal to XC1 plus XC2 plus XC3 divided by 3. So the mean reading is 1.2217 cm. The next step is finding out the absolute error. The difference between a reading or the corrected reading and the mean or the average reading is called absolute error. So absolute error can be find out. The next step is average absolute error. The average of absolute error is called average absolute error. So by using this formula, we can determine average absolute error. Next step is relative error. It is the ratio of average absolute error to mean or the average reading. In this way, we find out relative error. Step number 6 and the final step, that is percentage error. It is the product of relative error and 100. So percentage error is defined as a way of expressing a relative error as a fraction of 100. Percentage error is equal to relative error into 100, and we get the final answer as 0.0352%. So dear students, in the next video lecture, we will learn about significant figures, their rules, and the identification of significant figures. Thank you.